I'm advocating for cervical cancer elimination in the world. As a member of the WHO expert group on cervical cancer elimination, it's a volunteer group. And cervical cancer, what is cervix? Cervix is the lower part of the womb. Okay? So it's a point that is often prone to cancer. In short, between the age of 15 and 59, even in the world, in Africa, in Nigeria, cervical cancer is the most common cancer in this group, men and women. That's if you range all cancers. If you look at every person in the world with cancer, you'll find out that women with cervical cancer are the second. Okay? Then in terms of cancer deaths, women with cervical cancer are the second. And it's a problem. In short, as we speak, about 500,000 women are reported, new cases are found every year. And about 300,000 of women with cancer will die every year. The issue is that if we don't do anything, by the year 2030, when this sustainable development goal will be ending, these numbers will increase to about 700,000 new cases per year and 400,000 deaths per year. This is what we don't want, okay? But the cervical cancer is though common, but it's preventable. Why? Because it's been known to be caused by a virus, human papilloma virus, the high risk types. There are about 14 of them, but the two important ones, very important ones, that cause over 70% of the cervical cancer is the human papilloma virus 16 and human papilloma virus 18. So that's why you have two of them in all the vaccines available. Okay? So, and there's another peculiar thing about cervical cancer. You know, I can say it's a bit kind because it has a precursor stage, what I call younger brother. That precursor stage, pre-cancer stage, that lasts for a long time, up to 15 or more years. So you can identify it at that point, it's not cancer, and you can treat it, and the woman will be okay. So that's another peculiarity. Now, even the cancer itself has early stage and late stage. The early stage, when you identify it there, it can be cured with radiotherapy or radical surgery. Some centers in Nigeria can do that. But our problem in Nigeria is that our women present very late, when we can't do anything except just palliate them. So that is the issue. So based on these peculiarities of cervical cancer and the existence of vaccine, the WHO had developed a global elimination strategy. The point is that they want cervical cancer to be eliminated by the end of the century. Okay? And we can do that if we vaccinate 90% of all girls 9 to 14 years, if we screen every woman at age 35 and 45, and we treat every woman with pre-cancer and cancer, 90% of them, 90% of girls vaccinated, 70% of screening, and 90% of treatment. If you achieve this by the year 2030, by the end of the century, the cervical cancer will have been eliminated. And that means about 400,000 women. So my message here to the bishops is not because they can have it, no. It's because they constitute a credible group, okay? WHO said every nation that has the political will and do appropriate intervention can achieve this target. So political will, I know the government listening to the bishops, and that's why I'm here to advocate so that they can join me, join this everybody, and talk to the government to step up their activity. They're doing something, but to step it up so that, but we know doing all of them at the same time in the short term is difficult. But we know we can start with vaccination of our girls. Nationwide, we have the platform. We just started Pudio last year. So we can vaccinate these girls, achieve it. Even if it's them, those ones we can protect, that will be okay. So that's why I'm here. And two, there's this issue of inequity in cancer vaccine distribution. They are in the country, but well, on demand, if you ask for it, you know, the awareness is not very much there. It's there. Two doses is about 15,000 max per dose, depending on where you get it from. Okay, so it's available. But you know, when you make it a national immunization program, part of national the country will become free. The enlightenment will increase. And you're going to get access to a lot of people. So that is the issue, and that is why I'm here. There's this thing they call vaccine inequity. Because now, most of our vaccine, we are donated. But the developed world have the money. So they colonize this vaccine. That's why we have few cervical cancers in developed world. They've been screening their women. Now the vaccine is out now. They've colonized, buying up the vaccine and giving their girls. So I want the bishops to use their linkages to equally help us to break that inequity, so that when we start this national immunization, we can have the vaccines to give. So that's the two things. Advocacy, that's what I want them. They are strong voices. And I know when they come out with this, the government will listen. They can even help government get individuals and groups that can even support and bring money. So that's the issue. The Catholic Church has been in the forefront of health delivery and promotion. By the time I was born many years ago in Achina, there was no hospital around my area. I was born in Ihiala. It was Our Lady of Lourdes. It was a Catholic hospital. So that's why many dioceses have hospitals. One of the messages I brought to the bishops too is that why they are pushing on the government to do this national thing, they can use their assistant health commission to increase the awareness, start HPV vaccination, even in their schools too. But it has to be paid because they don't money. But they can get rich people to subsidize it. So that's another thing, the government approach and the Dyson approach. And I trust with the love the bishops have for health, the love they have for the congregation, I'm sure this message will be passed and something tangible will come out of it.